Hello and welcome to Insanity, the only series that gives you the best tips, tricks, and information on the game that we all love, Endgame. Oh wait, hold on, that series comes later. Let's fix that. Okay, that feels better and looks better. Let's go ahead and get started with Ingression then, the only series that gives you the best tips, tricks, and information on the game that we all love, Ingress. I, of course, am your lovable, enlightened instructor, Incredible Hulk. On today, we're going to cover Pro Tips 3. These are tips that will help you not only improve your glyph hacking game, but improve your inventory, increase your number of portals captured, and also double your MU captured on large fields. So some good tips here, but before I get started, I do have to give a huge shout out and a big thank you so much to Niantic and Ingress. In the last weekly email that they send out to every single player that subscribes, they included a link and a thing to Pro Tips 2. Thank you guys so much. We got a lot of views, a lot of shares off of that, and a lot of agents were able to be helped off of that. So thank you so much, Niantic. Obviously, the only thing we better be working for you, but in the meantime, thank you for the shares. And thank you guys at home for sharing as well with all of your friends. We try to keep this completely non-faction biased, so please feel free to always share this with every single Ingress player that you know. But anyways, enough of that mushy stuff. This isn't a Nicholas Sparks film. Let's go ahead and move on to Pro Tips 3. And Pro Tip number 1 is going to be, it seems like all of us higher level agents constantly have this problem we run into where we're low on level 4 resonators. We just can't find them in our inventory all the time. It's like we're Johnny Depp in Pirates of the Caribbean, and level 4 resonators are our rum, and we're just constantly going, why are the level 4 resonators always gone? But it doesn't have to be that way. A tip that was sent in by Captain Ron 77 that I had forgot about to specifically mention is when you're deploying on that portal that is a fresh portal, just remember, don't do a full deploy. Do your 8, your 7, your 6, your 6, your 5, your 5. Then you have a perfect level 4 portal to use. And we're used to kind of, you know, normally hacking this. But if you glyph hack that portal instead, pretty easy glyph hack, it's 3 sequences. You're actually going to get not just the regular 1 to 3-ish resonators, you're going to get somewhere between 2, upwards of 8 resonators off of that hack. So you're not only going to not lose inventory, you're actually going to build inventory over time so you don't have to do the glyph hack every single time. And then after you finish that, you can go ahead and fill out the rest of it, and you are all good to go. So thank you again, Captain Ron 77, for sending in that pro tip. And moving on to pro tip number 2, we were just speaking about glyph hacking. This is a glyph hacking tip that I actually didn't know until it was sent in by 2 players on the exact same day. So thank you, Adam Logan and pysankypittsburgh, for sending this in on the exact same day. And that is, let's say you get a glyph sequence that you just absolutely hate. Maybe it has open all, clear all, or maybe it has the imperfect glyph. The imperfect glyph, which I hate, it's the bane of my existence. I hate it, it's just my bane. It's just like, show. You believe that the glyph hack game is your ally. But you merely adapted to the glyph hacking game. I was born in the glyph hacking game. I don't know why I just did a bad Bane impersonation, but it is the bane of my existence, hands down. If you do not like the sequence that you got, just go ahead and hit the home button on your Android device, or even your iOS device for this one, and it'll actually take you out of Ingress, and you can go back into Ingress and re-glyph hack it and get a new glyph sequence if you really don't like it. However, as Robert Hughes mentioned to me, you do have to make sure you have done this before you have drawn your last glyph. So just make sure that before you've drawn your last glyph, if you even miss a little dot on there, you can also go ahead and hit that home button, reset again, and restart as well. It's not quite as speedy, but it will give you a higher level of accuracy if you were going to miss it on there. So that is pro tip number 2. Thank you, Adam Logan, pysankypittsburgh, and Robert Hughes for the little add-on. Now, pro tip number 3, also dealing with glyphs as well, is what is known as glyph cursive, a term coined by Jon Harmon, and that is learning to draw glyphs from any starting point so you can end near the next glyph for higher speed bonuses. And this was submitted to us by Mike Tolley, aka SpeedSr. Thank you so much for submitting it. So, for example, so you know exactly what I'm talking about if this doesn't make sense to you. Let's say that you have the glyph sequence, Shaper's Message, End Civilization. You would want to start your Shaper's glyph by drawing it on the right side, go up or around, finish it, and then be able to be right where Message starts. Draw Message, and right where Message ends, you're going to be starting the end glyph. And when you finish the end glyph, you're going to be right there, be able to start Civilization. So it's like this entire little cursive. Your school teacher was wrong. Cursive does, or if your school teacher was right, cursive does actually matter. Who knew that your third grade teacher would actually help you in Ingress someday? Aside from teaching you how to read the word hack. But So thank you so much, SpeedSr, for bringing this to our attention. So just learn that glyph cursive. It's obviously not going to increase your speed at first. You'll take a little bit longer. I'm actually horrible at this still myself since I learned about it. I'm working on it though. But it will increase your speed over time, and you'll still be able to get a pretty good accuracy on it, about the same accuracy as before. So that is pro tip number three. Now moving on to number four. This is one brought to us by Agent Solid Soul, submitted with some O's instead of O's, because we all know how hard it is to find a good agent name. Any of us that have tried to name change. Incredible Hulk is actually spelled with capital I's, not L's. I had to do that because the name was taken. So, and this is if you need to catch more portals. Let's say that you have a portal just barely out of your reach. It's inside of a building and you're 1 foot away. You're standing at the edge of the building, but no matter how hard you press your phone against the building, it just won't go through. You're not Kitty Pryce. You can't just go through walls. Or let's say that, you know, there's a fence there and you can't go in there without trespassing, or maybe an agent from the other team has set a very vicious dog on a 21-meter leash and placed the center right in the middle of the portal so you can't ever access the portal because that agent is a jerk. Well, there is a way around that. You have to be careful while doing this. I stress, please be careful when you do this. So what you're going to do is, if you're on foot, then you're just going to go ahead and back up as far as you can away from the portal. And just run at it. Just run towards that portal. Run like you're Mario and you're trying to launch off when he has the little raccoon ears. And then right when you hit that edge, obviously you want to stop before you hit the wall or the fence or the angry dog bites you in the leg. But this will actually, your phone's accelerometer and GPS lag behind by just a little bit, so they'll still think that you're moving. You'll get that extra foot or two, and you will be all good to go. Pretty much every agent I've talked to does not think this is any sort of spoofing. If it's, you know, just like at a little bit of foot, it's considered drift on that situation, and we all kind of honor the drift gods and respect that they are not spoofing with a drift on there. That's just a little bit, you know, maybe a foot or two on there. So thank you again, Solid Soul, for letting us know about that. I would say please do not do that in a car. Unless it's just complete open dirt, but then I don't know why you can't reach the portal. You just want to be safe in cars, obviously. So please, you know, don't run into walls with cars. If you run into a wall with a car, because you're doing this and you watch this video, I am not legally held responsible. The person who didn't teach you to be stupid growing up is legally responsible instead. So moving on, tip number five. As I promised, we're actually going to double your MU. And this is a really simple thing that you can actually do, and it's really going to be useful on your large fields. So I'm going to use this example field that I tossed a while ago. This is 150k. I actually used this field in order to get my Onyx Illuminator. So let's say you've tossed this field and it's right before your checkpoint. Let's say your checkpoint is midnight and you tossed it at 11:55. After the checkpoint, use a virus, destroy your own field at one of its anchors, and then re-throw it from the sides. This obviously only works with a maximum of 7 layers. In this case, this was a 7 layer field that I was throwing from one of the anchors. So all you have to do is go ahead and key farm 2 keys for each portal that you need along the way instead of just 1. Then all you have to do is destroy it with the virus and then throw it again after the checkpoint. You will double your MU. This obviously isn't as useful on small fields. You don't want to use this on a 2 MU field, considering how rare viruses are. But if you have a big field, 100k plus, this is a great way to go ahead and double it without having to drive all the way back out to that location again. And if you destroy your anchor with a virus and then retoss it immediately, you're not going to have to worry about someone tossing up blocking links in between. You know, maybe it's normally someone would torn it down before the next checkpoint and you would try to rethrow it, but you never know when blocking links are going to come up. The odds that someone is going to get a blocking link up there in the minute or two that you are Jarvising or ADAing your own portal and then rethrowing it is very, very low. So you are going to double your MU on your massive fields this way and get even closer to your Onyx Illuminator. So tie this in with your multi-level or multi-layered burrito field and you will get massive, massive, massive MU off of this technique. So that's it. Just go ahead and recap again for you guys. Just remember, when you're trying to farm or when you're trying to get level 4 resos, just do a deploy minus the last 2 resonators, then go ahead and hack it, and then deploy those last 2-4 resonators after there. Do the glyph hack for extra ones. If you need a new glyph hack sequence, just hit the home button. Learn that glyph cursive so that you can go ahead and start from any point and end near the next glyph for higher speed. And then if you do need to catch a portal, just kind of use your GPS and accelerometer lag to go ahead and just kind of run and then stop and then have a little drift about a foot or two forward on there. And if you do need to, if you want to double your MU on burrito fields that are 7 layers or less, use a virus in order to flip it and then rethrow it right after after the checkpoint on there. So once again, thank you guys for watching. This, of course, is Pro Tips 3. If you want to make sure that you always have the latest tips, tricks, and information on Ingress, just click that little subscribe button right there. That one right there, if you're not already subscribed. If you've already subscribed by now, I'm sorry. There's like a lot of people that watch these videos that don't subscribe, so please just click subscribe, and it'll make sure that you're always getting the latest tips before everyone else that doesn't subscribe to this channel. And of course, I always have a challenge for everyone out there. I have two challenges in this case. Of course, post your pro tips below that we haven't listed or said already, that I don't have, if I don't have a plan for a future episode already in there, and it's something that's not easily covered and is definitely a pro tip, you'll get a shout out just like the agents from this video did. Adam Logan, pysankypittsburgh, Mike Tully, aka SpeedSr, Jon Harmon, Solid Soul, and Robert Hughes. Thank you guys so much once again. So you'll get a shout out, and you'll also get your pro tip mentioned and help other agents. And then the real challenge that I actually want to do is I want to see who can get the best at glyph cursive. So I want to see who can get the highest speed bonus using the glyph cursive technique on level 6, 7, and 8 portals. So these are 4 glyph and 5 glyph portals. So I want you guys to take a screenshot and post below a link to your best speed time. Nothing below 70%, by the way. Nothing below 70%. That's unfortunately not a speed bonus that counts in this sort of challenge. There's some great people. There's people that get 84% speed bonuses on level 8 portals. So nothing below 70%, but I'll see who can get the highest speed bonus with glyph cursive. And those people, both the level 6, 7, and the level 8 person, will get a shout out in a future video. So thank you so much for watching. Go out there, glyph hack, have some fun, increase your speed bonuses, double your MU, and have fun playing.